Welcome to part one of the Atlas Copco Tensor SL tutorial series. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up your Tensor SL controller out of the box and how to network it via Ethernet with ToolsTalk PF software.
Once we get our controller out of the box, it's time to gather a few components that we need. We'll need our power cable, our SL tool cable, our Ethernet cable, and our RBU. First, we'll have to open up the back of our controller. To do so, pull the tab up vertically that's on the top, and while supporting the back, rotate it 180 degrees, counterclockwise, and rotate it up. Now you can simply open up the back and let it hang on the bracket. With the back of the controller open, we can now begin to attach the cables. I'll start with the 90 degree power adapter. Then I'll grab the SL tool cable. You'll notice along the rim there are several metal extrusions. Take the largest one and face it towards you. Then gently insert it upwards while rotating the top until it snaps into place. Should be firm. After that, grab your Ethernet cable and make sure you plug it into the port that says Ethernet. Finally, take your RBU, we have a silver RBU here, and plug it into the port that says RBU. And then tighten it down. Now that everything is attached, I'll pull up slightly on the back of the case and slide all of my cables into the gap. Then, close up the back, flip down the top, rotate it 180 degrees clockwise, flip back down. You're now all set and ready to go. Now that we have our power focus controller set up, let's configure the network options so that we could connect via ToolsTalk power focus. We'll hit the program button, go down the controller and hit right, go to network, hit right, and then hit right on Ethernet. Here we could edit our IP address, subnet mask, and default router. Hitting right will open the field, and then hitting the CL button will clear it. We'll use the IP address of 192.168.101.1. Let's make it .2 instead. If you're on a local network, you'll always want to start with 192.168. The next numbers after that will become the identifiers for the specific controller. The last number itself, which we have as 2, can be anywhere from 1 to 255. Doing that will allow you to have up to 255 power focus controllers on the same network, and you'll be able to connect to any individual one and control it from one copy of ToolsTalk power focus. We'll hit OK, and I'll leave my subnet mask at 255.255.255.0. The default router we could keep at 0000. Now we'll have to make some changes on our computer. I'm running a copy of Windows 8 on this computer. I'll go down to the Start button and hit Control Panel. Go into my Network and Internet. Going into my Network and Sharing Center. And then I'll go to Change Adapter Settings. Here we have our local area connection and the Wi-Fi adapter that's in this computer. I'll double click on my local area connection. And then I'll go down to the Properties tab. I'll select Internet Protocol Version 4, and I'll hit Properties again. Here we see that it has an automatic IP, but we want to change it to a static IP. So we'll click the button that says Use the following IP address. Here we will enter the same information that we have on our PowerFocus controller. 192.168.101. Now the last address, we can't have the same address as our controller. So I'll use the value of 1 instead of 2. Our subnet address automatically fills in to 255.255.255.0. So we'll leave that exactly as is. And we won't change anything on the default gateway. We'll hit OK, and then hit Close. And we could exit out of the screen. Next, we could launch our ToolsTalk Power Focus program. Back on our controller now, we'll hit the Store button,
and we're given an error that says a reboot is needed before the changes take effect. We'll hit OK and turn off our controller. Once it's shut down, we'll turn it right back on. Now our controller is booted right back up to the main screen. In ToolsTalk Power Focus now, we'll go to this top bar up here, and where it says Selected Controller, we will select Ethernet Power Focus. It tells us that there is no reply from the Ethernet. That's because we haven't changed the settings within the Power Focus software. By going under the Options tab, we could go into our settings. Here we see a field that says controller IP. We will change this value to the value that we put onto our controller, which was 192.168.101 and 2. Hit OK. And let's try it again. We'll change our selected controller back to Ethernet. We are now connected to our Ethernet controller. To verify that, we could open up this drop-down menu. Here's the IP of our controller. And now we have a full set of all the information we want, from setting PSETs to seeing the jobs. We could open up the Statistic Viewer and see our PSET that we had set here. We could open up our Trace View. We could do all this kind of good stuff through the software instead of having to do it on the controller. This also means that you could control your Power Focus controllers from anywhere on the network, anywhere you are in the building. You don't necessarily have to be on the controller to make changes. This helps a lot with the compact model that doesn't have a full keypad and full screen. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Make sure to tune in for part 2, where we go over creating a PSET using the ToolsTalk Power Focus software and viewing our results and traces on the computer. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below and we'll make sure to get back to you. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to subscribe for more product news and updates from Flexible Assembly.